This may look like some distant corner of the earth, but we're connected. Trade networks, bigger cities, airplanes, profoundly interconnected. Case in point, Ebola.
I'm Dr. Peter Daszak, I'm the president of EcoHealth Alliance. So what we try and do is predict where the next one's most likely to come from. And then we send teams out to those regions. We work with people on the ground, around the world, in the hotspots for emerging diseases. We try and help them change the way they have a relationship with wildlife. In the past 20 years or so, there's been more and more evidence that bats are the source of Ebola virus. And bats are also the source of SARS and other pretty nasty emerging diseases. You know, probably 1 in 1,000 bats will have the live virus at any one time, or less than that. And to catch a virus from a bat is not straightforward, you know. What happens though is people are eating bats, they're living in areas where bats maybe defecate or urinate on the food, and that's how this virus gets spread. It doesn't seem to make bats really sick, so there's some recent work out of CDC that shows a related virus causes a brief illness in bats, just like if we get the common cold. If bats are the source, how does it get into people? And it's pretty clear that bushmeat is a risk, and what we're talking about there are non-human primates. So somehow the virus is able to get from bats into non-human primates. Some of them die, and then people might find a dead ape or monkey, and they'll pick it up, take it home, butcher it, and catch Ebola from that carcass. And that's a well-known route of transmission. So we've not really had much close contact with bats as a species. We don't farm them, you know, like we do with domestic animals. You know, they don't normally live in and around very dense urban populations, but we are encroaching more and more into their habitat, and there are a lot of them. You know, it's about a fifth of all mammal species of bats. So I just think they happen to carry a lot of viruses. We're just getting in contact with them right now. Just like in China when we work with SARS, you can't go to those wildlife markets and say, hey, stop eating wildlife. This is something they've done for 5,000 years. What you can do, though, is say there are better ways to do this. So perhaps people could farm wildlife that are regularly eaten as food. Perhaps they can shift to a safer product from a safer area. Test them regularly and look for evidence of these viruses in the animals they're eating. And especially look for those first few cases of a new outbreak.